The year 2000.
Once we realized we'd survived the big rollover into the new millennium, the world breathed a collective sigh of relief.
All that hoarding of water, canned goods, batteries, plastic sheeting. What were we thinking?
Looking back, it's almost funny.
Almost.
2001.
Still here.
The novelty of surviving Y2K was long gone.
It was just long.
But then, things changed.
And all I could think of was what next.
But as the months went by, the fear slowly ebbed away, more or less.
And again, it was pretty much just long.
Life, never exactly the same as it was before. I spent some time drifting, thinking about things, and in March I got a job. It wasn't what I really wanted to do, but at least my parents were happy.
I interviewed with a dozen or so companies, and in July, I got a job.
For the first time in a long time, I felt something like hope.
A corner office. Decent salary. Cute secretary. What more could a guy ask for?
He was good looking, but not overly so.
A guy could ask for a lot more. He could ask for a life that wasn't all about work.
I'd never been able to fully trust guys that were too good looking.
I can't exactly remember how it all got started.
I remember exactly how it all started.
My first day on the job was a Monday.
Monday was all about post-it notes. I gave him a tour of the supply cabinet.
I got a brand new diary. Daytime.
Monday was also about pens, paper clips.
I remember I wore my lucky tie. Yeah, the ones with the dogs on it.
At first, he was standoffish.
At first, I couldn't get over how much he fidgeted.
Tuesday, I was relieved that he wasn't wearing that weird tie with the dogs again.
Was it a nervous habit? Or was it me making you nervous?
Tuesday was all about me. Well, it was actually all about my feet. I wore my sexiest pair of high heels, and my feet hurt so much that by lunchtime, I was contemplating suicide.
Those high heels were pretty hot. And she looked like she was having difficulty walking in them.
But Wednesday was all about lunch. Roti, 3 blocks north.
Meat pies, 1 block east.
Sushi, half a block south. Falafel, 2 blocks west.
She often ate her lunch at a desk.
Thursday was all about office politics. So-and-so and so-and-so, watch out for her and him and her. This is how I thought I'd bring him into my confidence, make him an ally, forge the secret bond that only backstabbing can create.
I wasn't into gossiping that much, but I have to admit it was pretty informative.
But Friday's where it got interesting, because Friday was all about the weekend. So, what are you up to? Big plans for the girlfriend? Oh, you don't have one? Well...
Okay, now I knew for sure. She was flirting.
Could he be gay? He was awfully well-groomed.
I was always a fan of having a crush on someone at work. It helped the time go by faster.
About 12 hours. In the whole time I knew him, we spent approximately 12 hours together. We might have actually got somewhere if those hours had been all in a row. We would have talked about things like how many people we'd slept with,
and
instead we talked about paper clips.
And post-it notes.
The little ones. What we're planning on doing for our holidays.
Going to see the folks. Maybe get drunk. Maybe go to the beach.
I say we spent approximately 12 hours together because after the first day or two, I started keeping track and tabulating at the end of the day.
She was very attentive, as far as secretaries go.
Each morning, it took him 27 seconds to walk from the elevator, past my desk.
Good morning.
And disappear around the corner on the way to his office.
Corner office.
In the winter, this jumped to almost a full 3 minutes while he changed his shoes and hung up his coat.
I think she appreciated the fact that I was a routine kind of guy.
Once a morning, he'd take a bathroom break, again walking by. I tried not to pay too much attention to him then. I wanted to respect his privacy and didn't really want to consider the details of his business.
Hey, I'm a routine kind of guy.
You know, when I was in university, guys were always asking me out. I turned lots of them down. I could afford to be picky about who I hung out with.
I walked by her desk from time to time to say hello or stop to ask for assistance, but not too often.
Random chatting at my desk, averaged 4 minutes per day.
This was the beginning of my professional career, over here.
And there were a few people who I thought were my friends, but I eventually had to cut them loose. People who treated me like crap.
I did not need the stigma.
I refused to let anyone treat me like that.
Of being the office pervert.
Over the years, my friends became fewer and fewer. Some got married. Some moved away. Then, well, one day I woke up and I realized that somehow, incredibly, I was pretty much standing all alone. Which was okay. Friends come and go, right? But once they were all gone, I realized there weren't too many new ones signing up.
I wish we could have met somewhere else.
On the subway.
At a dinner party.
In line at 7-Eleven.
Somewhere without rules.
I should have grabbed a husband when I was younger.
It wasn't easy meeting people, especially women.
Getting better looking.
She wore this unbelievable perfume.
With the exception of that tie, he was a great dresser.
I wanted to kiss her.
Corner him in the photocopier room.
So much, but it just never seemed like the right time.
Instead, I did nothing.
What was wrong with
me? I never used to feel so afraid.
Why couldn't I just make a move?
What was there to be afraid of?
She's just a woman, for God's sake. I'd known plenty of women.
I mean, people had affairs, or so they said. Talk shows were full of people had affairs.
It just never seemed like the right time.
Nothing's ever happened accidentally to me. Not the good stuff, anyways. If something was going to happen, I had to make it happen.
I'm worried about my job, her job.
And what if it was more than an affair?
I liked my freedom.
What if it was something more?
Then, fate stepped in. Well, one lunch hour, I ran into her at the dry cleaners.
So, I followed him to the dry cleaners.
I was picking up my suit jacket.
However, I hadn't really thought the plan through. I didn't actually have any reason to be in the dry cleaners.
I guess she was dropping off her jacket.
So I took off my jacket.
Which was kind of weird, because she was wearing a sleeveless top and it was getting cold now.
He took his suit jacket out of the plastic bag and put it around my shoulders.
I am, if nothing else, a gentleman.
It was so sweet.
The jacket looked really big on her.
For a moment, it felt like I climbed inside his skin.
For a moment, I could see our lives comfortably intertwined.
We walked back to the office together.
She went to her desk.
He went to his desk.
One of my personal philosophies has always been, seize the day.
Maybe tomorrow.
So the next morning I woke up and I thought human resource policies be damned. I was going to ask her out.
The day started like any other.
Morning.
It is, isn't it?
Lord, you look beautiful.
My job may not have been rocket science, but I was a pillar of efficiency. There was no one that could file faster, or take minutes better, staple straighter. I was the most pathetic person I knew.
Big decisions. I distinctly remember thinking this work that I was doing was really important.
Ate my favorite morning muffin. You would have thought the food would have tasted different, that I would have somehow known to savor it. Instead, I wolfed it down. Got indigestion.
Phone calls to make, papers to sign, all very, very important.
But I guess if I had had any intuition at all, I never would have gone back to the office that morning.
So important, in fact, that when she came into my office to drop something in my inbox, I didn't even look up.
I wish she had looked at me.
I should have just put down the phone and closed the door in. What if she would have pushed me away?
If there's one thing I could never take, it was rejection.
The details are fairly grotesque.
I'm sure you read enough about it in the papers.
It made front pages all over the world.
We really don't need to go over the details.
But maybe you've forgotten. I was in my office.
I was on my way to the washroom. Pretty lame for a last mile.
I was in my corner office. Which I was so damn proud of, with all those giant plate glass windows. And all that time looking out those windows, never once thinking they could be easily transformed into millions of razor-sharp shards of glass. And all in the blink of an eye.
I guess we were lucky.
At least it happened quickly.
They said we died instantly.
And although it was fast, it wasn't quite instant.
There were a few seconds.
Just enough time to realize those seconds would be my last.
Just enough time to have one Or two regrets. All those posters left unposted.
All those important things left undone.
Dreams left undreamt.
Kisses left unkissed.
Lovers left unloved.
And do you know what's really incredible?
It's that what we're most afraid of was each other.
Why?
Looking back, it's almost funny.
Almost.